Oh, that is super comfortable. I'm gonna be completely honest, you don't even need nearly this much. All you need is probably a nice 4-inch piece of wick. I just do this to make sure that I'm absolutely gonna have this fire started. Cause this right here will burn for like 10 minutes, man, 15 minutes possibly. It's just these are the sizes that I cut them, you know, when I was getting started, so. Yeah, people are probably like, man, he's wasting that. And it's very true. I am, because I don't need this much. Look at all that wax. Oop. Yep, don't always work on the first try. If it doesn't ever work, you just gotta fray it more, that's all. So what I do is I'll put that right in there just like that. And like I said, I always carry cardboard with me. We save all of our cardboard. I honestly don't think that I'll ever run out. Fit in there. Very pleased with the stove so far. I've seen just to let you know, when this thing gets too hot, and this is on any stove, you don't ever want to mess with the hardware on it and stuff like that and keep trying to make it move and stuff, because what it does is it gets so hot that it wants to stick, and if you go and break in that, then you're just ass out of luck. So you gotta kinda set it to where you want it before you go burning that fire. Because once it gets too hot, it wants that hardware will want to stick, you know what I mean?
So I wanted to wear my camping hat today, but it is super cold on the ears. So, won't be doing that today. Could be a little bit more hotter. Plenty hot enough now. Wonderful. Just wonderful. Ooh, look how hot that is. Nothing special, but I personally never got it that hot before with the smaller stove that that belongs with, because that belongs with my other stove, that grate, if you didn't see it. Ooh. Really hot. hands are getting super cold. Oh, this is a good one. It tastes phenomenal. I rolled me an extra big one today because it tastes so good. This is it for me. This is the, oh no. But this is the life. Seriously. You just can't ask for anything else. You know what I mean? Sure, there's better, but not to me. The great outdoors is where it's at for me. It don't matter which patch of woods I'm in, you know? I'm happy either way. So, just seeing who really watches the videos and who doesn't. If you guys can think of any like good meals to cook out, maybe you can throw out some suggestion. Maybe you could throw out some suggestions, and you know, if I know how to do it, I'll try it. We'll see, you know. It'd be pretty cool. What's good meals to cook over the fire, you know? So I shoved one of them, like, you know, the street workers or whatever, the construction workers, or whatever they are, how they always put these, like, orange flag poles or whatever in the ground, and that'll let them know where they're working at. Well, I found a couple on the ground and I took them. And this is pretty much like my porch now, you know? So I think that's pretty cool. Just pull that out and stick it right in the handle of the tote. Wedges in perfectly. And then I just put a little light on there. Got myself like a nice little porch light. But I would imagine this view right here that the camera's showing is fairly decent, you know? It's well lit up. And when I was behind that camera, it looked really good to me. So I was like, yes, let's capture that clip. Yeah, it is nice out here, though. That one sounds like an actual police chase. I wonder if I should put my gloves by these fire or by this fire when it's, you know, when it's time for go time. That way my hands will be nice and toasty. Cause it seems like no matter how good your gloves are, winterized, you know, when you grab those handles on that cart, it compresses all the insulation. So, your hands end up getting cold anyways. Well, your fingertips at least, you know. This fire feels amazing. Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed camping with me in the woods, cooking over the fire. I enjoyed it myself, and as always, till next time.